repeat. I put the dip in, it sound like I'm needy, but I'm like, oh, you too needy. Me and HB going Juvie and BG, they gotta put my face on no box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they compete. Salute when you see me. That's hardly ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM101 cheesy, and plus they got D2 on repeat. I'm with the love of my life for like 3 weeks, cause that's all I needed. She wanna go on a trip or retreat, but I'm sorry, I never retreated. I set the bar so high that you might as well leave it. I'm going undefeated, I've broken the system. Had to breach it, that's mission impossible, mission completed.
Salute when you see me, yeah. I got the heart of a god and a genie. I want you to love me, I want you to need me. When I this face is feed. I gotta get back to the hood, I remember when I was the needy. Clean me up, squeaky. She fell in love, deeply. They like what I say, they repeat me. Look, all this money I be spending on BBs. That's why you gotta salute when you see me.
Sports coverage of the NFL has us at newly named State Farm Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. So this was the scene a moment ago. The Cardinals emerging from their tunnel, and we are ready for football as the Cards get set to match up with Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers. The veteran kicker Mason Crosby set to do the honors here. And this one is underway here on EA Sports.
Omaha.
On first and 10, here's Murray. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Here's Murray. He'll dump this one off to Connor.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so, and gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Murray now on first down. He'll buy some time right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Even though it's the opening drive of the game, he wasn't shy about taking off and running with the football, even knowing the defense is definitely going to take their shots at him. And that's exactly what they did. He better learn to slide. Otherwise, he won't be around to finish this one.
Throwing again on second down. Murray, and this will be swung out here for Connor. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game, too. And he goes diving forward to try to get an extra yard or two. After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. Murray again. This is Connor. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Now the first carry for Chase Edmonds. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that's going to bring up a 4th down. They'll run for it with Connor. And he will have a 1st down here at about the 40. Just enough push up front. He only needed about 6 inches. He didn't get a whole lot more than that.
No, but he made sure he got enough so they didn't have to worry about measuring it or making it even close. Ends up picking up a couple of yards in a situation, as you noted, where he only needed inches.
First down, Murray. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Murray now. They'll roll him out right. That's Isabella open on the right side. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
They'll try and run for it with Connor. And just nowhere to go for Connor. Defense gets to him, and they mark him short. They're going to run. Here's Connor. And he's going to have the 1st down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line.
Well, that's what's called being aggressive right there. But I don't know that it's reckless. I think it's much more of a message, hey, defense, I believe in you in case we don't get it. And offense, trying to let them know he believes in them as well.
I like it. Your first drive of the game in plus territory. Be aggressive. On first and 10 is Counter. And he stopped immediately there. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
And now Murray's going to set up the throw. Steps away to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. For it, hits Murray, sliding out of the pocket. It's complete, swings it out to his running back.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense, they can't get the stop here. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. The counter, it's Connor. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Throwing now is Murray, rolling to his right. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
From the gun, Murray. He'll buy some time right. And Hopkins has got it. Touchdown, Arizona. DeAndre Hopkins, there to make the grab. And the Cardinals take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This one taken just inside the 10. And he's going to be out of bounds here right at the 20-yard line. And play action. It's Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 36 now, first and 10. On play action, now Rodgers. That'll be complete to Alan Lazard. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Now a play fake. Rodgers. There goes a deep ball. End zone. He hauls it in. Valdez Scantling for the Packers touchdown. Marquez Valdez Scantling. 42 yards. And the Packers have drawn even here with the extra point to come. Crosby connects on the extra point, and they take the lead here at 7-6. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And with 25 seconds to go, we'll see how they want to play this. Murray now on first down. That's caught on the left side by Kirk. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Throwing on first down is Murray. They'll roll him out right. To Connor on the check down. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. From the 45 on second down, Murray. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. Now a signal and a timeout call, as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. Again, they'll throw with Murray. Sliding out of the pocket. DeAndre Hopkins making the catch. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it. So on comes the field goal unit. This is a 49-yard attempt. Right hash. Prater's kick is good. And they jump back in front here. It's 9-7. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with 3.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. This one taken just inside the 10, and he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway.
It's been a tight game to this point. What do they need to do, Charles, to break through in the second half and take the lead?
Well, I think the first thing they need to do is thank their defense for keeping them in this game. And you know, I think the defense is saying back to them, why don't you guys focus on getting some first downs, put some drives together, give us a little bit of a break here. If we can get some rest, we'll play even better for you. And oh, by the way, pay off a few of those drives with some points, too.
And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Flush to his right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on third down. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. Well, he's going to go for it all. He hauls it in. Valdez Scantling for the Packers touchdown. Marquez Valdez Scantling. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And once again, the Packers, they're back out in front. Extra point up and good by Crosby. And the lead is up to 5. And the Cardinals hands team able to secure the football. The risk reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play. And here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them, and field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things. Now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
Steps away. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. Yeah, man, it's caught inside the 10. A huge play there for Arizona.
So when's the best time to take the big shots downfield? When you think a defense least expects it, and I think the first play of the third quarter qualifies. They came right out firing. That's how you send a message to start the second half of a game.
And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. They'll look to run with Connor. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. And this time, he is in. James Connor, excellent work there to get him on the touchdown run. And the Cardinals have once again taken the lead. Cliff Kingsbury going to decide here to leave the offense out and go for two. They'll try and run it here. And he'll get into the end zone to push the lead up to a field goal. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. Fielded right around the 8. And he's going to be out of bounds here right at the 20-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
To throw on second and 10, Rodgers. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Now the man from UTEP. This is Aaron Jones. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three. This is third and two. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. To throw, it's Rodgers. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now a first down carry by Jones. Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Shotgun now for Rodgers. This one swung out here to Jones. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A big play there on the catch and run.
Heady, heady, heady on that one, huh? Getting out of bounds before the 2-minute warning. They get an extra timeout, extra opportunity to move the ball downfield. Very smart football.
Down right around the 25. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. On second and 9, Rodgers drops it to Jones in the flat. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. It'll go as a gain of 4. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. To throw is Rodgers. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Marco Wilson. And the Cardinals have just about sewn up this football game.
Well, you knew you had to take some chances here with the clock winding down, needing a touchdown to win it, and that one might have just sealed their fate.
Yeah, and that's the nature of the 2-minute drill. The offense trying to go downfield and make their plays. But defenses, they're sitting back watching everything that they do, but not too far back. They want to be in position to make a play on the ball, and that they did.
The drive will start with Connor, and the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Murray to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Connor. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as it comes with 1:04 left to go in the game. It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. Back to throw, Murray. Buying time to his left. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. And this defense, they needed that one more stop to have any...